Hello dear students, in this video we are going to start with our chapter 8, that is Africa. This chapter is one of the chapters of final term syllabus. In this chapter we are going to study about the location, boundaries, political and physical features of Africa. We are going to locate Africa on the world map. Then we are going to study about the political and physical features of Africa with respect to map. So map work of this continent is very important. Okay, apart from this, like, we are going to study about the political divisions, countries and capitals of Africa. We'll also study about the mountains, okay, rivers and deserts and all rest all. Dear students, let's start this chapter. Now, first of all, you should know the location of Africa in the world, right? So, Africa is, you can see this Africa, the yellow part, this is Africa, which is to the south of Mediterranean Sea, okay? Then, to its east, see, north, south, east, west. So, to its east, we have Indian Ocean, that is southeastern part, and towards the western part, it has Atlantic Ocean. So, these are the water bodies that surround Africa. And next point to remember is that Africa is the world's second largest continent in the world. Okay, largest continent in the world is Asia. And after Asia, we have Africa as the second largest continent. Then, next point to remember is that equator passes through the center of Africa. Therefore, the regions around this equator are really hot and humid. You'll find there's a lot of equatorial forest over here, right? So next we come over here to the north of, over here it's written there that most of Africa lies within the tropical region, bounded on the north by Tropic of Cancer and south by Tropic of Capricorn. So the region Tropic of Cancer is just to the north of equator and Tropic of Capricorn is to the south of equator. So Africa is one of the most diverse places on the planet with a wide variety of terrain, wildlife and climates. You'll find variety of terrain is landscape there. You'll find variety of wildlife and as well as climates. And the world's longest river, Nile, is also in Africa. So here the same thing has been repeated that Africa is the second largest continent after Asia and it is a home to 54 independent countries from different cultures, which form different cultures with, they have different languages, customs, beliefs and traditional and religious ideas. Obviously, so many people from various cultures, various countries have settled there. So this country has a mixture of languages, customs, beliefs, traditional as well as religious ideas. Then towards its north we have Sahara Desert. Okay, then it has Great Rift Valley. So these are all the features of Africa: Sahara Desert, Great Rift Valley in the east. Then there's a belt of rainforest along the equator. As I told you, when equator crosses to the center of Africa, therefore there will be, so if this region is supposed to be very hot because of equator, then obviously due to the hot condition there will be a lot of rainfall. If there's a lot of rainfall, there's a lot of vegetation also over here. So equatorial forest you'll find over here. Then we have it has vast grasslands of grazing animals. Southern and eastern parts of Africa have savannas. Savannas are grassy plains where, which has few trees. So it's written over here, a form of dry plains dotted with trees and bushes, right? Then under the final decades of the 19th century, while most of the world had been under the European rule for control over some time, for quite some time, Africa was still a mystery to them. Mystery means people did not know about this continent, Africa. So, that is why Africa is known as the Dark Continent. So, why Africa is known as the Dark Continent? Because Africa had not been explored by people around the world. People did not know about this continent for many years, many decades, you can say. Okay, it was only the final decades of 19th century when people came to know about this continent. Now, next point to remember over here is, what are the reasons for explorers for not being able to access the continent? Access the continent over here means that could not reach this continent. Why the explorers could not reach this continent? Because of the reasons. There are three reasons given over here. First is presence of vast Sahara Desert in the north. Secondly, dense equatorial forest. Okay, and then hot and humid climate, which brought a lot of fear of diseases like malaria and sleeping sickness. So because of these three reasons, people did not dare to go to this continent, and therefore this continent was called a dark continent. Clear? So you can see some basic details of Africa is mentioned over here. Area size is given. Location mentioned over here. Just go through it. Highest point in Africa is Mount Kilimanjaro. Lowest point is Lake Assal. Okay. And the largest desert in the world is Sahara Desert. It covers this much distance. Okay. And longest river is River Nile. Please, up till here we are going to study in this video. In the next video, we are going to start with the location.